Hello folks, this is Moss for Logmaker 360 and this is the third video about Arduino programming. And in the first video we set up a simulation Arduino environment, and in the second video we take a look at the serial monitor, and in this video we go to the second building block, which is selection.
And this is the same code as we used in the previous video about the serial monitor, but now we enter a value inside the serial monitor, and then we are going to compare this incoming value with a fixed number, which is 20 over here. So when the incoming temperature is equal to 20, double equal sign means is equal to, then we write down temperature is nice and we set the LED high, and else, so if it is not 20, else we print the value and not equal to 20, and we set the pin low.
And inside the simulator we click on run, and it asks me to enter a temperature, and you'll see that the LED is off, pin 8 is low, and it's 17 degrees. I click on send and it says 17 is not equal to 20, and then I turn my heater on and it's 20 degrees, and I click send and it says the temperature is nice, and puts pin 8 high. As you can see over here, the LED is burning red, and if we forget to put the heater off, then it's 30 and it says 30 is not equal to 20. And it turns the LED off again. So I modified the code a little bit and I put two more LEDs on there. So now I have a red LED, a green LED and a yellow LED. And I set the pin mode to output. So I have three LEDs and they are all outputs. And what I modified is if statement over here is checking or the incoming temperature is smaller than 18, and if it is smaller, then it is running this code, and if it is not smaller, then it is checking this condition over here. And this condition means if the temperature is bigger than 23, then it's executing those lines. But if it is not smaller than 18 and not higher than 23, then it jumps to this, to else, so what is left, so the gap between. And it will write down that the temperature is nice and set the green pin high. So three LEDs, 8, 9 and 10. 8, 9 and 10. Y from yellow, G from green, R from red. And over here, 8, 9 and 10 are all 0. If I start the program and enter a value of 15 and press send, and then it says it's cold and it sets the LED high. If I enter a value of 30, then it tells me that it is hot and it turns the red LED on. And if I made the temperature 22, then it selects the green LED and it writes down the temperature is nice. Okay, folks, stay tuned, because a line like this looks very complicated for the first time, but it's very easy. It be two conditions, this one and this one, and in between there is a and sign. So this means and. So what this is saying is that the incoming temperature is not allowed to be smaller or equal than 4, and the incoming temperature is not allowed to be bigger or equal than 18. So everything what is between 4 and 18 will be executed in these lines. And if it is smaller than 4 or bigger than 18, it will jump to this else statement. We have another one, and that's those two pipes, and that means OR. So this is saying if the temperature is smaller than 4, or the temperature is bigger than 55, and then it will execute this. Like if it is above 55, it will say beware of heat damage. And if it is below 4, it will print something like beware of frost damage. You can nest if statements inside if statements. So we have an if statement here. And if it is true, we go to this if statement. So if it is below 4 degrees or it is above 55 degrees, then we go to this if statement, which is checking is the temperature below 4. And if that is true, it checks or the temperature is, and this means not equal to 3. So if it is 3, it will not print this line. Only if it is below 3. So this means is not equal to 3. So if it is 3, it will execute this line. So in a nutshell, this means greater than, this means less than, greater than or equal, less than or equal, equal and not equal. That's what you have to remember. I will leave a link of the code in the description of the video, so you can play with it. It probably looks confusing, but if you play with it, it's a lot of common sense, and you will pick it up very easy. I recommend you to write your own code, not only copy it, but start from scratch. And take this as an example, and with this simulation software you can light on the LEDs. This is the end of the video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Have a look on it. I have a lot of videos about sensors and Arduinos. Take care and see you in the next video about the switch statement, which is another selection tool we have. Thanks for watching.